Welcome back to the channel. I'm going to show you guys the transform function under resolve effects. So if we open the effects tab and we go to the open effects menu, down at the bottom here, there's a resolve effects transform. You have the transform and the collage. You might think this is just like your regular transform that you'd get from your overlay controls right here. So if you click on your video clip under the inspector, under settings, you always have a transform where you can slide stuff around, zoom it. Typically, I use that for picture changes or overlays, but this transform is a little bit different. So we're going to click on the clip here and move over to the effects tab. Now you can see we have a transform under here. Now there's some controls. We got sliders, interactive canvas, and pins. Sliders is a little less intuitive because it's on screen, and I'll show you what I mean in a second. We're going to switch our on-screen controls to Open Effects Overlay, and then you'll see nothing happens because we're in sliders mode. So here, if we use sliders, you get some of the same functionality, but it's a lot easier, in my opinion, if we use the interactive canvas. So now we have a grid that's kind of like the surface tracker, and what you can do is grab the corners and move whatever item. If you're using a PNG or something with the title, say you're going to overlay something on glass or a logo, you can use this to fit it in. And then you can track it with the controls in here without having to go to the Fusion page. You can adjust your text separately. So if you want to zoom this out, you can kind of line it up where you think it would fit on the plane properly. Right now, we're just kind of covering where the window would have been. I'm hit Z to zoom back to normal. You don't have to be perfect with this, just as long as you get it where you like it. We're kind of just covering this area here. And if you grab this center section, it'll move everything in Ucision versus if you grab a corner or one of these other quadrants, it's going to affect that area only. So now that we have it roughly where we want it, there is a way to animate this with keyframes, but it works a little differently than your other keyframes. So if we go back over here to the inspector, we have image adjustment, and depending on what graphic you're using or what you're overlaying, you can kind of soften it and round it. Then there's this animation here. And if we look, we have canvas keyframes right here along with a motion blur. And there's just a single dot to make a keyframe. It's kind of unintuitive. But if we park on the first frame and we just click the keyframe so the diamond turns red, that basically records the on-screen position. Now if we go to the last frame of our shot here, we can adjust this one more time, and that's going to make a new keyframe for us. So I could see that our outline has moved a little bit, and I'll just place it roughly right back where we had it. Now if you want to compare it, you can use your bracket keys. There's our first keyframe, and our bracket to the right, and there's our last. So you can kind of see the perspective change. Looks like this is a little bit higher based on what I can see underneath here in the middle. So we can move it up, and that's probably good enough for this. So let's go back to the start. I'll hit P for full screen, and we'll hit play. And now we have a title tracked into this window section on the edit page using the Resolve Effects Transform feature. All right, so I hope you guys found that useful. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you guys on the next one.